There are more vape pens or jewels in the halls of high schools. They're just getting harder to find.
And they used to be easier to find because they were larger.
Kathy Charlton has been the principal at Hempfield Area High School for about 20 years, and she's never seen anything like the vape problem.
It plugs into a USB port, so you can plug it into a computer. And at first, teachers had no idea. They thought that they were just
flash drives
or something that was legitimate. So that's how they charge these.
Just look at how many vapes have been confiscated from students this year. It's a big box. So who is vaping?
If I had to estimate, I'd say about 75% of my classmates or more.
That is an unscientific poll, but Marissa Dean and other students say lots of their friends are vaping. Why?
As like technology's increasing, there's easier ways to hide it now.
Vape pens are just so much smaller than they used to be. This was popular last year.
This one concerns me because you're sitting in a classroom, the teacher's walking around the class, and you're just sitting there like this. You might have your chin on your hand, but really you're vaping.
Another reason more students are vaping, it's not seen as being as dirty as cigarettes. Some of that vape juice smells really good.
This one has a fruity smell.
Yeah, it smells like fruit.
Yeah, this one is one of the fruity ones.
It smells very nice.
It does.
Which is part of the problem.
That's right.
She says teenagers don't think it's dangerous.
It is dangerous, I think.
Chemistry teacher Tom Harden's students have tested vape juice to see what's in it. They found often it's exactly what the labels say, a lot of nicotine.
If you pull the top off of the Juul, this is the pod that goes into the Juul. And this pod, the vape juice in this pod, corresponds to a pack of cigarettes. So you're getting a huge hit of nicotine really fast when you're vaping.
Sometimes kids who are caught vaping say they're using vape juice with no nicotine. But Kathy says most of them are not 18 and cannot legally buy vape juice, meaning they got it from a friend and really they have no idea what's in it. She says many students are quickly getting hooked.
You do have students who are now addicted to nicotine.
Yes.
Because of vaping.
Yes. Yes, we do. And it doesn't take very long for them to become addicted.
She recently caught a student vaping marijuana oil. He was obviously high, she says, and he was expelled. The police are investigating. She has this advice for parents. Yes, even the parents of the quote-unquote good kids.
Check their backpacks. Look for vapes. And I always say this. You're the owner of the home. Check their rooms, check their backpacks, check their phones. If your child tells you that you can't have their code to their phone, disconnect their service. Be in control, be a parent, and take charge.
Explaining to your teenager that all vaping can be dangerous is a good first step, and lots of teenagers are finding the strength to resist the intrigue of vaping.
I think the whole concept is kind of dumb. If I wanted a good flavor, I'd eat a piece of cake. So I don't need vapor in my lungs.
And I should point out that the two students I interviewed said they've not tried it and they just think it's silly. And so some kids are not doing it, and they also did not have the same advice for punishment that the principal had. Yep. They do not want parents going through their stuff.
Yeah.
But sometimes that's what you gotta do.
Hats off to the principal. I mean, I was watching, you know, from a mom perspective.
Yeah. Right.
I'm a few years away from that. Mm-hmm. Hopefully I don't have to deal with that. But there's many people at home probably saying, you know, this is eye-opening.
If you have a teenager, you gotta be aware of it.